हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी शैल लर्न अबाउट चैप्टर 8, दैट इज सिमेट्री ऑफ एलिमेंट्स। यू हैव सम आइडिया फ्रॉम योर प्रीवियस स्टैंडर्ड, दैट इज फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड 4, अबाउट सिमेट्री। नाउ व्हिच आर सिमेट्रिकल ऑब्जेक्ट्स? सिमेट्रिकल ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर दोज व्हिच कैन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू टू इक्वल हाफ्स। That is, the two equal halves will be identical in size, in shape, or in pattern. Now, the line which divide a symmetrical object into two equal halves, that is called axis of symmetry. For example, take one example, say this is a figure, and for this figure, if you draw a line, say this is a line, this is the line, and here this line is drawn through the middle of this figure. Now, if you observe the two halves, the upper portion of this line, that is this part, and the lower portion of this line, that is this part, these two halves are in equal in size, in shape, and in pattern. So we can say that this is symmetrical object and this is the axis of symmetry. Now, this type of line, that is called horizontal axis of symmetry. This is the horizontal line, and this is the line, this is called vertical line. This vertical line, if you draw this vertical line, then you will also observe that the two halves of the vertical line, that is this part and this part, these two parts are also equal in shape, size, and pattern. So this figure has both the horizontal axis of symmetry as well as vertical axis of symmetry. So there are two types of axis of symmetry, one is horizontal, another one is vertical. Now take the example of this figure. For this figure, you can see if we draw the horizontal axis, then two half are equal, two halves are equal. Whereas if you draw a vertical line, this half is not equal to that half. So it has only horizontal axis of symmetry, but it has no vertical axis of symmetry. That is, if you want to find out horizontal axis of symmetry, then you have to draw a horizontal line and you have to look at the upper portion of this horizontal line and the lower portion of this horizontal line. If the two portions are equal, then we can say that it has horizontal axis of symmetry. Whereas if you want to find out vertical axis of symmetry, then you have to draw a vertical line, then you have to look at the two part of the vertical line, that is this part and this part. If these two halves are equal, then you can, or similar, then you can say that it has vertical axis of symmetry. Now for exercise 8.1, the first problem is you have to find out symmetry of the alphabets. You have to find out symmetry of the capital letters of the alphabets. For take the example, that is A. A has, you can see here, it has only vertical axis of symmetry, because you draw the vertical line, then you will observe this part and this part, these two halves are equal. So A has vertical axis of symmetry, whereas A has no horizontal axis of symmetry, because you draw here horizontal line, this part is not equal to this that part. So A has only vertical axis of symmetry. Similarly, B has only horizontal axis of symmetry. For B, this is the horizontal line, this part is equal to this part. Whereas for vertical line, if you draw vertical line, this part is not equal to this part. So B has horizontal axis of symmetry. C has also horizontal axis of symmetry, it has no vertical axis of symmetry. D has also only horizontal axis of symmetry. E has only horizontal axis of symmetry. Whereas for F, there is no horizontal axis of symmetry as well as no vertical axis of symmetry. That is, F is not symmetrical, it has no axis of symmetry. You draw here horizontal line, there is no symmetry. You draw here vertical line, there is no symmetry. For G also there is no symmetry. This is not symmetrical. For H you can see here both the symmetry lines are present here. So H has both the symmetry line. I has also both the symmetry line, J has no symmetry, K has only horizontal axis of symmetry, L has no symmetry, M has only vertical symmetry, N has whereas no symmetry, N has no vertical axis of symmetry whereas no horizontal axis of symmetry, O has both the vertical and horizontal axis of symmetry, P has no symmetry, Q has no symmetry, R has no symmetry, S has no symmetry. Because if you draw here horizontal line, this part of S is not equal to this part. That is, one half of S is this type and another half of S is this type. So this half is not equal to that half. So S has no axis of symmetry, T has only vertical axis of symmetry, U has also only vertical axis of symmetry, V has also only vertical axis of symmetry, W has also vertical axis of symmetry, whereas X has both type of symmetry axis, vertical as well as horizontal. Y has only vertical axis of symmetry, whereas for Z there is no symmetrical axis, because if you draw the horizontal axis then there will be no equal halves, so Z is also not symmetrical. So these are the letters. So from this solution you can do all the solution of all the problems given in question number 1. Now question number 2. This is the oval shape. For this oval shape you can see here it has both the vertical axis of symmetry as well as horizontal axis of symmetry. For B, this is the picture of a bulb. It has only vertical axis of symmetry because this half is equal to this half. This is kite. Kite has also, you can see, it has only vertical axis of symmetry. This half is equal to this half. But if you draw here horizontal axis, then this half is not equal to that half. So it has no horizontal axis of symmetry. This is the aeroplane. So here you can see also it has horizontal axis of symmetry because that half is equal to this half. Whereas this is the picture of laptop. You can see here it has vertical axis of symmetry. If we draw a line like this, then this half is equal to this half. Whereas if you draw here horizontal axis, then this half is not equal to that half. So it has only vertical axis of symmetry. It has no horizontal axis of symmetry. So this is all about exercise 8.1. Thank you.